Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us on Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates. A newly built Tupolev Tu-160 long-range heavy strategic bomber, the first one since 1992, was rolled out of the hangar as Russia resumes production of the world's largest operational bomber that NATO designates as Blackjack. The new Tu-160, which is nicknamed White Swan in Russia, was revealed at the Kazan Aviation Factory, a branch of Moscow-based Tupolev Design Bureau, on the 16th of November 2017. The aircraft was built using parts stored since Soviet times to establish if the factory was capable of resuming serial production of the legendary bomber. The bomber will now undergo testing on the ground before taking to the skies in February or March of this year. The serial production of Tu-160s is remained stalled since 1992, will resume after the aircraft proves that it matches the assigned criteria. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the capabilities of Tu-160M2 and its lethal weaponry.
Number 5.
Blackjack is the largest combat aircraft in the world, with maximum takeoff weight of over 275 tons. It can cover a distance of more than 12,000 kilometers without refueling. The record distance it covered during one flight was 18,000 kilometers, spending more than 24 hours in the air. The bomber is equipped with variable sweep wings, which it wedges against the fuselages when switching to supersonic speed. As of 2017, the Russian Air Force long-range aviation branch has at least 16 aircraft in service. The bombers proved their effectiveness during Russia's air campaign in Syria as they took off from airfields in Russia to strike terrorist targets.
Number 4.
The Tu-160 is a variable geometry wing aircraft. The aircraft employs a fly-by-wire control system with a blended wing profile, and full-span slats are used on the leading edges, with double-slotted flaps on the trailing edges. The Tu-160 has a crew of 4. The Tu-160 is powered by 4 Kuznetsov NK-32 afterburning turbofan engines, the most powerful ever fitted to a combat aircraft. Unlike the American B-1B Lancer, which reduced the original Mach 2 Plus requirement for the B-1A to achieve a smaller radar cross-section, the Tu-160 retains variable intake ramps and is capable of reaching Mach 2.0 speed at altitude.
Number 3.
Russia's military announced the decision to resume production of modernized Tu-160 M2 variation back in 2015. The serial production of the bombers is likely to begin in early 2020s, with the Defense Ministry planning to purchase at least 50 aircraft. In the short term, Russia will buy an initial batch of 10 aircraft. The modernized planes will get new improved engines and will have analog onboard equipment replaced with digital hardware. The Russians expect the addition of the upgraded Tu-160 M2 into the arsenal will improve the capability of their nuclear triad. President Vladimir Putin said, "It's a serious step to advance the development of the high-tech industry and strengthen the country's defense capabilities, because it's one of the elements of our nuclear triad." Moscow can make do with the upgraded Tu-160 M2 for its strategic bomber force because, unlike the US Air Force, the Russian Air Force does not expect the massive aircraft to penetrate into enemy airspace to deliver its payload. Instead, the Tu-160, capable of speeds of over Mach 2.0, would dash into position to launch long-range standoff cruise missiles. As such, stealth is not considered to be particularly important. One new feature will be the ability to drop precision-guided munitions, PGMs. The Tu-160 was built without the ability to use laser-guided bombs, unlike America's B-1 and B-2 bombers. The Tu-160 M2 version will have the capability to drop PGMs. The Tu-160 M2 is not likely to replace the long-serving Tupolev Tu-95 Bear. The two bombers will likely operate side-by-side for decades to come. Michael Kaufman, a research scientist specializing in Russian military affairs at CNA Corporation, said both platforms will have to coexist at the same time, like the B-52H and B-1B for the US.
Number 2.
Tu-160 M2 weapons are carried in two internal bays, each capable of holding 20,000 kilogram or 44,000 pounds of free-fall weapons or a rotary launcher for missiles. Additional missiles may also be carried externally. Tu-160 M2 will deploy the Radula KH-10X through rotary launcher. The new weapon is an extremely long-range stealth cruise missile. The missile would use a combination of inertial guidance and satellite navigation using the Russian GLONASS system. Some reports indicate it might have an imaging infrared terminal guidance system. Radula KH-10X comes in two variants. The KH-101 is the conventional variant, and the KH-102 is the nuclear tip variant. The missiles might have a range as great as 3,100 miles, as per some Western estimates. However, Russia media indicate that the weapon has far greater capabilities. In 2012, the Russian newspaper Izvestia reported that the conventional variant of the missile would have a circular probability of error of less than 30 feet at ranges of up to 6,000 miles. The missile's warhead would pack 880 pounds of explosives. The raid in November 2015 by Tu-160 on the Daesh targets in Syria marked the combat debut of KH-101. There's not much data available about the KH-102, which is the nuclear version of the cruise missile. One can presume that the nuclear variant will be at least as long-ranged and just as stealthy as the conventional variant. It will also likely travel at treetop levels and is thought to cruise at about Mach 0.77. The nuclear warhead is thought to be a 250 kiloton device.
Number 1.
The Russian stealth bomber PAK-DA is also expected to enter production in the next decade. A full-sized mock-up of the much-hyped stealth bomber was assembled last spring, but will probably not go into production until after the Tu-160 M2 production line closes. Russia simply doesn't have the resources to fund two bomber programs at once. In the meantime, however, the Tu-160 M2 should prove perfectly capable for years to come. The bomber's improved capabilities with increased numbers and lethal cruise missile will be a new strategic challenge for US and NATO military analysts.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.